must learn comes mainly from the outside world and is best expressed in the language of the outside world. So the quickest way around both these snags is to learn a foreign language first, but from a teacher to whom this language is also foreign.
Morning, children.
Morning,
sir. Sit down. Now we are going to practice verbs, present, past. Kneel down. Kneel down, Zima. What are you doing?
I kneel down.
What did he do, Najemba?
He kneels down.
No.
He kneels down.
That's right. Now, drive a motor car. Drive a motor car. Samakula, what are you doing?
I am driving a motor car.
What did he do?
And it's not just a question of learning the language. You've got to use it, think in it, calculate in it as well.
The second type is 20, 140.
No.
And this when you spend all your time out of school speaking your own native tongue. So whilst learning this new language and all the knowledge that's wrapped up in it, a child must divorce his mind from a totally different background.
Speak up.
The prophet is three shillings.
Now this one.
The prophet is 6 shillings. The road is 7 shillings.
The prophet is 3 shillings.
But it doesn't matter how hard they struggle. For most of these children, this primary school is all the education they'll get. Shortages of trained teachers, shortages of money, shortages of equipment, shortages of buildings, all decree that out of, say, 200 children, perhaps only these 10 will go on to any kind of secondary education. So that if they're lucky enough to get a secondary education at all, the odds will have been 20 to 1 against them. And now they're moving into the alien world of a modern boarding school, staffed mainly by foreigners. To some of them, a white man may even seem more than a foreigner. He could almost be from another planet. But you're just a teacher, and for the next few years, this is the class you'll be teaching.
Good morning. Sit down, please.
A whole village may have scraped together just one boy's fees. The education you can give them is the greatest privilege they know. All right. They're all yours.
I'm going to go through the list of your names now. I should like you to answer your names if you're here, and to correct me if I pronounce them wrongly. Ogume?
Present.
Aisenene?
I am present, sir.
How do you pronounce that?
Aisen.
Aisenene. Wandinga?
Present, sir.
How do you pronounce it?
Wandinga.
Wandinga. Kimululu? Kimululu?
Present.
How do you pronounce that?
Teachers like this man are the backbone of schools in developing countries. Of nearly 2,500 secondary school teachers in East Africa, for instance,